In this video, we're going to compare the Fuma 2 Rev B to the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 4 using this test bench right here. Before we get started, let's look at some qualitative metrics. Both CPU cooler images show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, neither cooler will have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Additionally, both coolers each use two 120mm fans, and it is possible to add a second fan on both coolers. In regards to installation, both are relatively easy to install, while the Dark Rock is slightly more difficult due to the closed top coupled with a loose mounting part that can be challenging to place. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over 1 million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the Fuma 2 cooler in red to the Dark Rock cooler in blue, both coolers perform similarly across the board. However, given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we see that both coolers perform similarly across the board. However, when considering sound, the Dark Rock Pro performs much quieter than the Fuma 2 for a given percent speed. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that both CPU coolers remain in line with each other and can barely handle overclocked temperatures. For the second set of comparisons, we'll look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis, while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the coolers by normalized noise levels, we see that both coolers perform similarly across comparable noise levels. And as we increase the watts to 105, we can see that the Dark Rock Pro begins to slightly outperform for a given noise level. And as we increase the wattage to 125, we can see that this trend continues. Overall, both coolers perform similarly for a given percent speed. However, the Dark Rock Pro 4 performs slightly quieter, making it the winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.